Basic Pediatric Airway Anatomy by Dr. Steven Rosenblatt and Dr. Nicholas Wolter.
Normal respiration requires air to pass through the nose and mouth into the pharynx, through the larynx, and then down to the lower respiratory tract. Obstruction at any of these sites can lead to respiratory distress, and depending on the site of obstruction, can prevent intubation and necessitate a tracheostomy. The larynx itself is divided into three contiguous areas: the supraglottis, which includes the epiglottis, false vocal folds, and arytenoid cartilages; the glottis, which includes the true vocal folds themselves; and the subglottis, or region immediately below the true vocal folds. The subglottis is the only part of the airway that is made of a complete cartilaginous ring that is called the cricoid cartilage. The trachea is made of a series of U or C-shaped cartilages. The pediatric larynx differs from the adult larynx in several important ways. First, the pediatric larynx is funnel-shaped, with the most narrow point being the subglottis within the cricoid cartilage, whereas in an adult, the narrowest point is the glottis itself. Another important difference between the adult and pediatric larynx is that the laryngeal structures overlap in an infant, almost like sections of a telescope. The hyoid bone sits over the thyroid cartilage, and the thyroid cartilage overlaps the cricoid. This will stretch out with age, but in an infant, the hyoid bone can make palpation of the thyroid cartilage landmarks difficult. And because the thyroid cartilage overrides the cricothyroid membrane, cricothyrotomy is generally not possible in children. Finally, the pediatric larynx sits higher and more anterior in the neck than in an adult patient.